हेलो डियर ऑल, दिस इज सदानंद मलिक, वेलकम्स यू इन एंटायर फिजिक्स एंड टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट श्रोडिंगर वेव इक्वेशन। एक्चुअली डियर, श्रोडिंगर वेव इक्वेशन इज नथिंग बट द डिफरेंशियल फॉर्म ऑफ वेव फंक्शन। जस्ट एज इफ अ पार्टिकल इज मूविंग देन ऑब्वियसली अ वेव पैकेट इज एसोसिएटेड विद द पार्टिकल एंड द वेव पैकेट इज मैथमेटिकली रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय वेव फंक्शन। So here, Schrodinger wave equation is differential equation of wave function. Actually, just as Newton's law of motions are important in classical mechanics, same as Schrodinger wave equation plays the role in quantum mechanics. Means, in most important derivations, Schrodinger wave equations are utilized. Means, Schrodinger wave equation have various applications in the field of quantum mechanics. So here, today we have to discuss about Schrodinger wave equation. So, Schrodinger wave equation is, this is differential form of, differential equation of wave function. Now, actually Schrodinger wave equations having two types. First, Schrodinger wave equations are of two kinds. One, first is time dependent form. Time-dependent form, and second is time-independent form. Time-independent form. Actually, when the wave function equation of differential equation of wave function depends on time, means time-related terms are there, then we say that is the time-dependent form. Similarly, if we find a differential equation of wave function which is totally independent of time, means there is no time related term, then we will say that is time independent Schrodinger wave equations. So here, let us consider the first one. First, time dependent form. To derive the time-dependent form of Schrodinger wave equation, let us consider a particle of mass small m moving with velocity v along x direction. Along x axis. Full stop. Then at any instant t, at a position x, the wave function associated with the particle is defined as, we know the wave function is given as psi function of x comma टी इज इक्वल्स टू ए मीन्स एम्पलीट्यूड ई रेस्ट पावर माइनस आई ई अपॉन एच क्रॉस माइनस इंटू टी माइनस पी अपॉन एच क्रॉस इंटू एक्स. सो दिस इज द वेव फंक्शन सपोज इक्वेशन नंबर वन. नाउ द टोटल एनर्जी ऑफ द पार्टिकल इज डिफाइंड एज द टोटल एनर्जी ऑफ द पार्टिकल इज डिफाइंड एज एक्चुअली द टोटल एनर्जी ई इज इक्वल टू काइनेटिक एनर्जी प्लस पोटेंशियल एनर्जी ऑफ द पार्टिकल. हियर काइनेटिक एनर्जी मे बी रिटन एज 1/2 एम वी स्क्वेयर प्लस बिकॉज पोटेंशियल एनर्जी डिपेंड्स ऑन द टाइप ऑफ फोर्स विच इज एक्टेड अपॉन द पार्टिकल. सो हियर बिकॉज द टाइप ऑफ फोर्स इज नॉट डिफाइंड दैट्स वाई लेट अस राइट द पोटेंशियल एनर्जी एज वी. नाउ लेट अस अल्टर दिस इक्वेशन. सो काइनेटिक एनर्जी मे बी रिटन एज पी स्क्वेयर अपॉन 2m प्लस वी. हाउ वी कैन राइट इट पी स्क्वेयर अपॉन 2m बिकॉज काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज इक्वल्स टू 1/2 एम वी स्क्वेयर. लेट अस मल्टीप्लाई m इन न्यूमरेटर एंड डिनोमिनेटर देन वी हैव एम स्क्वेयर वी स्क्वेयर अपॉन 2m इज इक्वल टू नाउ एम स्क्वेयर वी स्क्वेयर मे बी रिटन एज एम वी होल स्क्वेयर अपॉन 2m. नाउ हियर एम वी मीन्स पी स्क्वेयर अपॉन 2m. सो फाइनली वी कैन राइट काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज इक्वल्स टू पी स्क्वेयर अपॉन 2m. सो दिस इक्वेशन गिव्स द टोटल एनर्जी ऑफ द पार्टिकल सपोज इक्वेशन नंबर 2. नाउ ऑपरेटिंग द वेव फंक्शन ऑन बोथ साइड ऑफ इक्वेशन 2. इक्वेशन 2 is operated with the wave function, with the given wave function. Then we have E psi is equals to P square upon 2m plus V psi. Now, obviously, we have found the operator value of energy and momentum. So, here we know operator values of energy and momentum. Operator values of energy and momentum. E is equals to I h cross del upon del t and P is equals to h cross upon I del upon del x. Now substituting these values of E and P in this equation, then we have I h cross del psi upon del t is equals to here because 2m is constant, so 1/2m is taken common, p square. P square may be written as h cross upon I del upon del x whole square into psi plus here we can write v psi. Now on solving we have is equal to h cross square upon 2m into del square psi upon del x square into I square plus v psi. Since I square is equals to minus 1, since here we can write आई स्क्वेयर सिंस आई स्क्वेयर I square is equals to minus 1. Therefore, we can write minus h cross square upon 2m del square psi upon del x square plus v psi. And in left hand side, we have I h cross del psi upon del t. Now, here this is a differential equation of wave function. This is a differential equation of wave function. Now, suppose this is equation number 3. This is equation number 3. If we study about the equation 3, then we found here in the left hand side, it is time related term, and in the right hand side also, because the wave function psi, that is the function of x and t, because here the considered psi is a function of position as well as time. It means that equation 3 depends on time, but it is differential equation also, means here the terms which are differentiation of wave functions are existed. That's why this is time dependent Schrodinger wave equation. This is time dependent Schrodinger wave equation. Now, from equation 3, it is clear that if we do something so that this time related terms, suppose this is this and this, this time related term will be replaced by time independent form. So here, to do this, let us consider equation first again. Now, because we have the wave function psi, that is function of x and t, is equals to, we can write this psi as a, that is amplitude constant, e raised to power minus I e upon h cross into t into exponential I p upon h cross into x. Now, here in this equation, on right hand side, we have three terms. First one is a, second one is exponential related to t, and third one is again exponential related to x. Here, the second term depends only on time, and the first term a and the third term e raised to power I p upon h cross into x, first and third are independent of time. So here let us write first and third together and the second term isolated from them. So here we can write a e raised to power I p upon h cross into x into the second term at last, exponential minus I e upon h cross into t. So here we have this type of terms. Now in this equation, because this term having amplitude as well as the exponential term, the only difference is that this exponential term is related to the variable x only. That's why here these underlined terms behaves as a wave function, because here amplitude as well as exponential term existed. Now, because it depends only on the position, that's why we can say that this is a type of wave function which depends on position only. So suppose this is denoted by psi 0, that is the function of x only, and here the time related term is exponential e minus I e upon h cross into t, where psi psi naught is a function of x and its value is equal to a e raised to power I p upon h cross into x. Suppose this is equation number 4th and suppose this is equation number 5th. So here psi x comma t is equal to this. Now again from equation 3 we can find that, you know, it is clear that we have already found the value of psi. Now again we have to find del square psi upon del x square and del psi upon del t. So let's try to find this. Then we have differentiating here equation 4th. Differentiating equation 4th partially with respect to x. We have del psi upon partially differentiating equation 4th with respect to x, then the time related term will be treated as constant. So here del psi upon del x will be equal to here the exponential term is time related term, so it will be treated as constant. So here exponential term will be as constant, means e raised to power minus I e upon h cross into x will be as constant. Now the differentiation of psi naught with respect to x is del psi naught upon del x. But because we need del square psi upon del x square, means again differentiating partially with respect to x. So here again this exponential term will be treated as constant. So write it as it was. E raised to power I e upon h cross into t. Into here the differentiation of this term with respect to x will become del square psi naught upon del x square. So this is equation number 6. Suppose it gives the value of del square psi upon del x square. Now let's come to equation number 3. Then finally we have to find del psi upon del t, means partial differentiation of psi with respect to t. So here we have differentiating equation 4th with respect to t partially. Then we have differentiating equation 4th partially with respect to t. Then we have del psi upon del t is equal to, now the position related term will be treated as constant, means here now del psi 0 x will be constant and the exponential term will be differentiated. So here psi 0 will be as it is and exponential term differentiation e raised to power minus I e upon h cross into t, and the differentiation of power means I e upon h cross. Now suppose this is equation number 7. So from equation 4 we have the value of psi, from equation 6 we have the value of del square psi upon del x square, and from equation 7 we have the value of del psi upon del t. Substituting these values in equation number 3, then we have, let's try to write, then we have using equation 4th, 6th and 7th, comma equation 3 becomes. So here equation 3 may be written as, because equation 3 was I h cross del psi upon del t and the value of del psi upon del t is given by equation 7. So it is psi naught into e raised to power minus I e upon h cross into t into minus I e upon h cross is equal to minus h cross square upon 2m minus h cross square upon 2m into del square psi upon del x square, and del square psi upon del x square is given by equation number 6, means exponential minus I et upon h cross into del square psi naught upon del x square, del square psi naught upon del x square plus v into psi. V psi means psi 0 e raised to power minus I e upon h cross into t. So here exponential term are present in both the sides. So on right hand side, if we take this exponential term common, the this exponential will be cancelled out with the left hand exponential term, and finally we have h cross and h cross will be cancelled out, and now I into I is equal to I square. So I square is minus 1, that minus 1 and this minus will become plus. So finally here we have on left hand side e psi 0, this e and this psi 0 is equal to, on right hand side we have minus h cross square upon 2m del square psi 0 upon del x square plus v psi 0. Obviously here v is potential energy and e is total energy. So here let us transfer this v to the left hand side. Then we have e minus v psi 0 is equals to minus h cross square upon 2m del square psi 0 upon del x square. Now transferring this 2m to the left hand side and h cross square also to the left hand side, then we have 2m upon h cross square into e minus v psi 0 is equals to minus del square psi 0 upon del x square. Now transferring this whole term to the left hand side, then it will become positive, means del square psi 0 upon del x square plus 2m upon h cross square e minus v psi 0 is equals to 0. Now look this equation carefully. Suppose this is equation number 8. Now if we study about equation number 8, then we find that here no terms which is related to time, and also here the wave function psi 0, that is the value of psi 0 is equals to a e raised to power I px upon h cross, means it is totally independent of time. It means that in equation 8 there is no term which depends on time. So here, but it is differential equation also, because here psi 0 is going to be differentiated with respect to x. So this is the differential equation of wave function. So here this differential form of wave function is known as time independent Schrodinger wave equation. So this is time independent Schrodinger wave equation.